I'm Morgan Spurlock, and I'm a documentary filmmaker, and I have a movie here at South by Southwest called Where in the World's Osama Bin Laden? So I'm such a bad blogger. Like when Super Size Me came out, I was really good about, updating things that were happening because it was all so exciting, and it's almost like I was sharing like my whole journey with all my friends and everybody who was back here in the States that that helped us sell the movie and set the movie up. And kind of after that, I got to be a very bad blogger, updater. Well, the thing is, for me, it's like I look at film, I look at the movies that I get to make and the TV show that we have on FX. Like that's really my chance to kind of say something and to explore a topic. So for me, it's like I really try and pour most of my energy into my work, into my film and television shows, and. I love to read blogs and I love to read other people's thoughts and opinions. And, for me, I'm, just a documentary filmmaker. I don't really want people to take my opinion. I want people to make up their own. The biggest thing is you have to have something that kind of incites a dialogue. One of the best blogs I think that's out there is the guy who wrote Freakonomics has an incredible blog where he continually updates information and everything. Sometimes he puts up stuff that really does just, fire people up, and suddenly there's thousands of people responding to a post. I think that if you can do something that really does start to push people one way or another, that then people will become involved. It'll spread like wildfire. And I think that and it's also the great thing that's happened with the web is really niche oriented. It really is about finding, I write about X, and this one thing that you write about, while it may be small to most people, but there's still thousands of people all over the world who still want to read about X and read about this. So I think that if you can find whatever, the biggest thing for me that I tell people is you have to be true to you. You have to be true to your voice and what you want to say. You don't want to write about what somebody else thinks or what somebody else does. You really want to kind of find your own voice and vision. And when you do that, you will start to find people who agree with you or want to talk to you or want to interact with you automatically. There's a few different reasons why I come to South by Southwest. One's because I love Austin and I love this festival. It's a festival that actually is much more low-key and relaxed, I think, than especially a festival like Sundance, which is an incredible place to go, but it's much less stressful to come here. It doesn't have kind of the push to like go, 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 sell, sell, sell. It's a little more laid back, and real people go see movies. It's not just about people who are in the industry, which I really like. So for me, it's what I love to come to Austin for is I love to bring, we had a film here last year called What Would Jesus Buy? We have a film this year, which is my new movie, Where in the World's Osama Bin Laden. It's a chance to kind of get people to see it, to talk to real people, to get their feedback, to kind of build a little more momentum before the movie comes out. It's going to open in about a month. And also, we've just also launched a company that I've become a part of called Cinelon. And what Cinelon is it's an initiative to help filmmakers make short films and get them distributed to film, television. There's movie theater chains that are basically going to put these up. Like, so when you see a trailer, there'll be a 3-minute doc from Cinelon that's made by, any filmmaker in the world. And the whole goal for me is to help filmmakers make a living. It's to be a documentary filmmaker and actually make money is hard. And if we can in some way, help create a business that somebody who's a teacher or somebody who's an accountant that's kind of making movies on the side, to be able to be a full-time filmmaker and a full-time artist would be an incredible accomplishment. There's so many outlets and resources where you can look at about how to tell a story. How do you put together a beginning and a middle and an end? And for me, the greatest teacher I had was watching movies. I think that's a great place to really learn structure, is just watching other filmmakers and learning from them. One of the things we're trying to do with Cinelon is there's a filmmaker advisory board that's made up of like myself, Steve James, who's here, Stanley Nelson, who's also at the festival, Eugene Jarecki, Jessica Yu, filmmakers who have made, two or three movies. And what we do is, one of the things we help is mentor filmmakers. So filmmakers who come to us with an idea, we help shepherd them through the process of how do you make a film? How do you really, tell a cohesive story? So I think that, I grew up in a world in West Virginia where my parents really instilled in me the idea of you have to give back, each one teach one, and I think that as a filmmaker, you do have an obligation to help other filmmakers. For me, a documentary, and what a documentary means, is to capture a story as it unfolds in real time. And I think that, for me to make a film, the key is for me to be honest with me by being honest with myself as I make a movie and the things that we're doing and what we're creating, then I'm going to be honest with you, the viewer who's actually going to watch it. So I think if you, just go in with that objective, that I'm going to be honest, I think that's a great place to start.